Okay, we are going to study standard form today. And what is standard form basically? When you have to express very large numbers or very small number in an easier way, then you use standard form. What is a standard form? Basically, this is your standard form, a into 10 raised to the power n. Now, definitely you will be thinking, what is a and what is n? Now, a is basically a number in standard form which ranges from 1 to 10. And n is power of 10. So it is an integer, n is an integer, and it basically tells you how many times 10 will be multiplied in a number. If n is 2, suppose if n is 2, then definitely 10 power will be 2. 10 power 2 means you will multiply 10 2 times. If n is 3, then you will be multiplying 10 how many times? 3 times. Okay, so first case is very large numbers. If you have to express very large numbers in standard form, then what you will do? So write 35,000 in standard form. Now, first of all, identify where is your decimal in 35,000. Decimal is present at the last here. In standard form, you have to move your decimal after your first digit, which is 3 in this case. So you will move your decimal from the end immediately after 3, that is over here, and you will count the number of digits that you have moved. You have moved 1, 2, 3 and 4 digits. So 10 raised to the power will be 4. That is the number of digits that you have basically moved. Now, what about the sign of this power? For sign convention of the power, you need to memorize this rule. If you will move from right to left, then n will be positive. In this case, I have moved my decimal from right to left, and that is why I have chosen positive sign for n, which is power of 10. So my answer in standard form for 35,000 will be 3.5 into 10 raised to the power plus 4. Here a is 3.5, this one, and it is between 1 and 10 according to our basic definition for a. And n is 4 plus 4, which is an integer. Case number 2. For very small numbers, and you have to express them in standard form, then if I ask you to express 0.000464 in standard form, then again you have to identify your decimal place. This is your decimal number, this is your decimal point, sorry. And you have to move your decimal after first non-zero digit, which is 4 in this case. So you will be moving your decimal until you will place it immediately after 4. So place decimal after 4, it will become 4.64 into 10 raised to the power minus 4. No. Minus 4 comes from where? 4 is basically the number of digits that I have crossed in moving my decimal from here to this point. And minus sign is basically because you have moved your decimal from left to right, and for that purpose n will be negative while moving from left, moving your decimal from left to right. So your answer is 4.64 into 10 raised to the power minus 4. The third case here is adding or subtracting two numbers that are in standard form. Now consider this case. Work out 3.18 into 10 raised to the power 11 plus 3.22 into 10 raised to the power 11. Now I have two numbers that are in standard form and I have to add them. You can take out common the power of 10 because both the powers of 10 are same. 10 raised to the power 11, 10 raised to the power 11. So take out common 10 raised to the power 11. I will be left behind with 3.18 plus 3.22 within the bracket, and we will be solving the terms within the bracket, and upon addition of 3.18 and 3.22 I will get 6.4 multiplied by 10 raised to the power 11. Now this is my answer in standard form, that is addition of two numbers in standard form. The next one is a bit different example of addition of the numbers in standard form. I have two numbers, 2.4 into 10 raised to the power 6 plus 2 into 10 raised to the power 5. Now you need to focus on the point that we have different powers of 10. Now in this case I will take the power of 10 common, but the power which is the less one. So 10 raised to the power 5 is less as compared to 10 raised to the power 6. So I will take 10 raised to the power 5 as my common, and I will be left with 2.4 into 10 raised to the power 1, because 10 raised to the power 5 is taken as common. So I have left with only 10 raised to the power 1 over here, plus I have left with 2, and this 10 raised to the power 5 is taken out as common. Now solving within the bracket, 2.4 into 10 is 24, and adding 2 you will get 26 into 10 raised to the power 5. Now this 26 is not in standard form because my decimal is after 6. I will move my decimal immediately after my first digit, so decimal will come after 2. Because I have moved one digit, I have placed my decimal one digit from after 6 to after 2, so my power here will be 1 and it will be plus because I have moved from right to left, from right to left. So 2.6 into 10 raised to the power 1 will be conversion of 26 in standard form, and 10 raised to the power 5 is present already here. So bases are same, 10 raised to the power 5 and 10 raised to the power 1. When bases are same and they are being multiplied, I will add these powers, 1 and 5 will become 6. So my answer will be 2.6 into 10 raised to the power 6. Then we have the case of multiplication of numbers that are in standard form. If you have two numbers and you have to multiply them and they are in standard form, then the trick is simple. Multiply the numbers 8 and 4 and you will multiply the powers of 10. That is basically they will be added because bases are same, 10 raised to the power 3 and 10 raised to the power 7 upon multiplication will be 10 raised to the power 3 plus 7, because when bases are same and we multiply them, then you add the powers. 7 plus 3 is 10. Now this is 8 into 4, 32 into 10 raised to the power 10. Now convert 32 in standard form, because decimal is after 2, I have to move this decimal immediately after 3. So I have moved one digit and I have moved from right to left. So I have to add one power in this power of 10. So adding 1 in 10 will become 10 raised to the power 11. The last case is dividing numbers that are in standard form. If you have two numbers and both are in standard form and you have to divide them, first of all express them in division form. Now you have to simplify the numbers 6 and 2. Upon simplification it will be converted into 3, 2, 3 times 6. And now I will be solving my powers of 10 as per the rules of indices. I will move 4 in the numerator. Because bases are same, I can move this power in numerator, and when this power will move into the numerator, I will change the sign of this power. It is plus in denominator. When I will move in the numerator, this 4 will become minus 4. 5 minus 4 is 1. Your answer is 3 into 10 raised to the power 1. That's all about standard form. A basic concept of standard form is given here. Subscribe the channel so that you can get updates of all the topics of math regarding O levels, A levels, CSS, GSA, and of all grades. Thank you so much.